Well, hello everyone and welcome back to the Model Workshop. Today I'm going to be building up Atlantis Toy and Hobbies 1/24th scale Mack Bulldog steak truck. This is the AC Mack, the 1926 Mack. It is a four-cylinder, 40 horsepower truck. This is a monster. 5.5 ton truck is what it represents. You can see it's got solid rubber tires, solid metal wheels. This thing rode like a buckboard because that's pretty much what it was. It even had a chain drive final on this thing. It is a no frills work truck, and that's how we're going to build it up. This is a reissue of the old monogram kits. You've seen me build the logging truck with the three big white pine logs that I made them look like on the back, and that was awesome. We weathered that one. This we're going to build up just a little different. This is going to be a fun build. We're going to get into it right now. So let's take a look at all the parts that are available. This was sent over by modelroundup.com for review. I will link down in the description where you can snag this, and it is in stock as we speak at this moment. First, molded in a bright opaque yellow, a very glossy yellow too. Look at the shine on that. We've got some of our body parts here. We've got a very simple firewall. These trucks don't have a lot to make them run. They are quite simple. You can see the design of the firewall with just some wires and some access panels there. We got those awesome metal wheels, the spoked wheels. We've got cab parts here with just a little mold in there. Not very much at all. We've got our front fenders. It has an old copyright date on it of 1974, when this mold must have been designed. So you can tell the vintage of it. Atlantis Toy and Hobby purchased a lot of the old Revell slash monogram molds and reissues them, and we get to build the vintage goodness that comes from it. We've got a multi-piece cab on this thing. You're going to see it go together in this video. We've got a nice windshield. Framing around the windshield and everything looks awesome. We've got transmissions. We've got that little Mack emblem, the early Mack emblem before they had the Bulldogs on every truck. We got our front bumper. It's just like a plank of wood. Back of the cab, drive wheels in the back. We've got the top of our radiator. We've got our radiator cap or motometer, some of them call them. They're a little fancier. We've got that Mack bullnose hood. That looks pretty cool with all of its vents in it. Nice design on there. And the molds look crisp and ready to go. We've got our stake bed with wood simulated planking. We'll be able to show you how to turn that into wood. We've got our frame. This goes on top of the frame to support the stake bed. We've got our sign placards. These are the little grooves that will fit in there, so we can do our Ringling Brothers like it is on the cover. What else we got going on? We got our stake bed sides. Love these. We got our tailgate. Wood on the inside and the outside. Wood grain. I don't know if you can pick that up. Then we've got our stakes on the side, all done in wood. Then we've got our hard sides, solid sides. They do have a wood grain to them, and of course you don't have to make them look like wood. You could make them look like painted wood, just like they do on the box art. I'm digging that scheme, if you can't tell already. As of this time, I haven't decided what I'm going to be painting or what I'm not going to be painting or how I'm going to decorate it up, but by the thumbnail you can tell which way I went when you saw this video come out. Now I'll switch to the other side of the table. We'll go over the rest of the parts in the kit. First is this gigantic manual. It's almost like a set of blueprints on this thing. It is huge, gives you some history of the truck, lets you know it's in 1/24th scale, and that's where I got that it's a four-cylinder, 40 horsepower engine from Mack, and that it's a 5.5 ton truck. If your references disagree, go argue it with someone else. Tells you how to paint the model, tells you how to decal it, all the different options. You can do an open cab, partially enclosed cab, cab with a windshield, everything, you know, cold weather cab. Tells you how to build the frame. It gets all in, and the instruction manual is just massive on this thing, and they give you all your options inside. Then we've got some black molded parts trees, our total frame. So really this truck pretty much wouldn't require much painting at all. We got the black seat, which I don't think I'm going to paint. It's got wonderful texture, and it definitely simulates the pleather vinyl black leather glossiness that it would have had back in the day. We got our steering wheel with our advance on it. We've got our engine transmission halves. Got our big beefy leaf springs. We've got retrieval hooks. Check out the rear suspension molded in. This will be your driveline here. Front suspension molded in. Then we'll have to add the other halves of the leaves. Got all these fine linkages which will go on. Luckily the frame's all one big color. Not a bunch of different colors on there when we build it. And then on this tree we've got that cool chain final drive. And I love that it's got the slack built in. That's nice because it really would. It's a big heavy duty chain. We've got our Mack 4-cylinder 40 horsepower. Got our front axle. Beefy enough to hold this truck up. We've got our exhaust pipes. We've got our floorboards, which have probably been wood or black like this. And then various small pieces. We got some pedals. We got frame braces. We've got various, we got our headlights here, which look really cool and old timey. So we got excellent parts here. And from what I remember, they go together quite well. Pulled from the parts tree in Indonesia. We got our solid rubber tires. I love these. These are a little difficult to sand because I don't own sockets this big. I don't work on vehicles with sockets that big. So we can flat coat these with an acrylic. Don't use an enamel, but just use an acrylic. You'll be just fine. Nice tread pattern on there too, and it's kind of shallow. So I probably don't want to sand these anyways. Then we've got some clear parts for you to use. We've got marker or tail lights. We've got headlights and windshield options. Crystal clear. You can barely tell they're there. And finally, we've got the decal sheet. On the decal sheet, we have options for Ringling Brothers. We have options for Tidewater Trucking. We've got some cool vintage license plates for 1926. We've got the small scroll work. So this part is done for us. All this little scroll work. We got the Mack emblem right there. And then all the trim work, if you choose to use it, around the front and everything, must be cut from this piece of black decal sheet. So it's not individual stripes. That's one decal sheet. Cut them, it says, 1/32nd of an inch wide with a straight edge and apply them and slice them off. So that's how you can work with those decal sheets. Now, I know for a fact that the Atlantis kit decal sheets are always a nice thin decal that molds perfectly, so you shouldn't have any problems using them. I'm going to start gluing my Bulldog together and I'll be right back.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's an extended assembly process, but it builds into a nice truck, and it's got a good amount of decal. It's got numerous linkages, steering boxes, all this stuff will go on towards the end. I want to apply them as separate pieces. Same with our seat here. I want to make sure that that goes on more towards the end. We get that in there with our steering wheel. I got to do a little brass detail in there. I just want to make it look kind of nice. The Circus rig, even though it's a work truck, let's make it look kind of cool and do it our way. Then we've got all these sides and whatnot that I want to do. Now, they do have the wood grain in them, but of course, in real life, you can do natural wood, you could do painted wood. I really like the box art. I think that's pretty cool. So I think I'm going to try to do it up in that, or a version of that. So we've got our box sides, the front railing, and the back has a tailgate, which is right here. Then we've got our front wall on this part. We don't have much detail on that. These are our sign placards, like I discussed. We got to paint these, and we can either leave it painted wood, or because there's wood grain, we could do detail the outside of it as well in a wood grain. And that is it for the stuff that we're just going to be throwing into paint. We got our wheels here. We got our hubs we can paint up. We've got our transmission shield. That's what I think it is, lower of the engine flywheel shield. That's going to bolt onto the bottom of the firewall there. We've got our nice toolbox for sitting underneath the cab here. Right about there is where that toolbox will sit. It's got some cool looking steps that will go in here. We've got that four banger all done. You can see the intake, carburation, the intake manifold, the exhaust manifold, hoses and lines. It's a little hard when it's all black, but we'll get it there. We got our front motor mount, everything on there that we need. We've got our large exhaust pipe that even has a hanger to go underneath. We've got this canister, which may be a fire extinguisher. I'm not really sure. I didn't look in the instructions to see what it is, but that bolts onto the fender here. So that's going to look awesome. We got our hood as a separate piece with a hood hinge if you want it to hinge, or you can just place it on and off, which is the way I do it, because it's hard for me to hold that hinge up, and I don't want to put a toothpick in there when I take my pictures. The hood ornament goes in here. We'll apply that last after I detail it. Got our vents. We can just use, after we paint this our preferred color, we can just use a marker. We've got our hood ornament, our front bumper, all set up so we can get into stuff that we assembled. I want to do the interior pan and the underseat storage of the fuel can is all one color. Then we will apply our shifter, our pedals in there, detail everything the way up that I desire, or you can paint that the cab color, whatever you want to do. But this is a Circus vehicle. We don't know, you know, they could have done anything they wanted with it over the years. We've got our wooden deck. That I'm going to detail on its own, apply that to the metal framework. Now, technically, these pieces here are wood, but I'm not going to do that. I'll just do it all as metal. All as black steel, scuff it up, maybe give it a little rust. We got the cool cab. You saw how that went together. It does take a little bit. Hold it steady. Now, the glue I like to use on this stuff is Plastruct Bonding. Works quite well, doesn't usually take too long to tack up. And then as you can see, we've got all square seams. Everything looks lovely. Everything holds together, and that's a nice strong assembly. You don't have to worry about that. I already scrubbed it off in the sink, so I can use a little bit of that. We've got our radiator, our little motor meter will go on the top. And then we've got our light mounts, all kinds of stuff on the cab. And then the cab sits beautifully over the front fenders. And on this one, I put the windshield in it. Figure it'd be an all-season vehicle. Glued everything tightly, and now it's nice and strong. That's why I'm throwing it around, just to show you how nice that Plastruct works and quickly. Got our front fender assembly. Don't snip off these pins here. Those pins go into our nice chassis assembly right in those grooves. And that's one way you can make sure that you've built your chassis straight, is by seeing that those holes line up and the fenders line up. Everything looks awesome on there. The chassis is a nice, really nice piece of work. Now on the logging truck, I did it in a yellow. This one, I'm going to do it in a black. Accent the chains, do a little rust detail on it. As it's a real truck being worked, I really weathered the logging truck. This one I'll go lighter on. We've got all of our hooks, front and rear. Make sure you apply the hooks so that they aim as if they had to pull it out either way. That's what those are for. Got our shifter here into the top of the transmission transfer case. We've got our drive shaft, which will feed it from the engine, go through that loop, feed all the way back. The engine will mount in this little hole here. I don't know if you can see it. It's hard with the black. That little hole there, and then the motor mount sits in the front. So it'll end up down in here, and I'll have to make a tight fit since I did attach the front of the frame like I did on the other one. It is a very tight fit, but it will drop in. You'll see here. See it going in? So just be careful with it. You'll get it in there. You won't have to fight it too badly. And what I'm going to do now is get all this stuff over, decide my paint scheme, get it all over to the paint department, and I will see you there.
Thank you. Thank you.
There's no mistaking that I love these old Mack trucks. I never had a chance to build them when they were monogram releases. Now Atlantis bought them, and Atlantis is actually putting them out. They did the logging truck last year. They've got this awesome stake bed truck this year. So we're gonna look at all the components, and then I'm gonna put it together, do my final details, and have the final reveal. I've got the front bumper ready to go. That will go on as one of the last pieces. I don't wanna keep breaking that off. Got the little fire extinguisher on there. Now, some of these parts, of course, aren't going to be the perfect restoration. If I was building an old Circus truck out of the old 26 Mack AC, this is how I would have done it. So I'm going to do my own little personal details. Got our toolbox, and I did some of that metallic dry brushing on that, and that can go on either side. I've seen pictures of them on the driver's side, I've seen them on the passenger side, so it doesn't really matter. You can just put them wherever you'd like. You don't have to put the front bumper on. Some don't have it, some do. We've got the steering wheel here. Most of them did not have brass accents, but if I was working on a fancy Circus truck, I would put those timing adjusting stuff on in a brass. And then we've got our steering box here. That will actually go in and attach right there towards the end after I get the cab in place. When the cab is in place, we've got our hood, and I remove the hinge so I can just attach it like so and just push it in place. So that's how I'll be doing the hood on that one. And then I can remove it to show off the engine. The cab will slide down over our interior. It'll be a very tight fit, but we'll get it in there. We've got the interior glued to the chassis, glued to the fenders, which are glued to the frame. We got that awesome little four-cylinder underneath the hood. And I did some dry brushing on that, as you saw. Rusted out the exhaust manifold. Did some light rust on the frame. Did that metallic accentuating so we can see the chain drive, and that looks pretty awesome. The wheel and tire package, and then I did darker hubs in the center just so we didn't have a total yellow out of everything. I also dry brushed the metallic color inside the wheels. I don't want a brand new, fresh job. I want something that gets used and that they just kind of refreshed and gave it a new life, and they still operate it, you know, but a lot original. You can see underneath there, we've got the exhaust in. We've got all kinds of cool brake linkages and all that on there. Really, these are such fun trucks. The cab is set to go. You saw me accentuate the sides of the radiator. We got our little mini moto meter. I've got the windshield in this one, and I've got the glass in place. It's so clear you can barely tell, but you can see it reflecting there. Got our grab handles on. Can you see inside? It's near impossible. You see those little black dots? Those are the gauges that are molded in. I reached in there with a black wash and filled those in. So now we've got those all set. Our steering shaft will come up through here, up through the actual dash, and then we will attach our steering wheel once that's in place. And it's hard to see, but you'll be able to see it once it's all set. So I'll be able to do that once the cab is in place and I can slide it in and glue it all in place. Got the little emblem for the hood. That looks pretty cool. Now we do that separately so I can get the detail. Pretty much what's left to attach are my headlights. The lenses all fit into all of this stuff with a friction fit. So we got our headlights. We've got our little marker lights that'll go up on the cab here in these little holes. On the chassis itself, we've got the tail light in place. Looks so cool back there with its little red lens. And then we've got our shift levers up. We got our shift lever and our brake lever up through the floor. They even connect and go all the way back. I mean, it's just a really, really cool kit. The stake bed, got our signs on there. Like I said, I did a little bit different than the box art and then a little the same. Wanted to do my own. Got our stake bed there with just minor wear. Got the yellow and black, and then I did the yellow for the steel rails underneath to accentuate that, because you can see all of it. So this thing is going to look so cool. We'll get the cab down there. We'll get some decals on. Now, I'm not going to go with all the black pinstriping. I simply don't have time today, but I will be putting on the Mack logos, maybe see if we can get the license plates on the frame, and then see if we can get some of those points on there and floors there. We'll see what we can do to make it look nice. So I'm going to finish all that stuff. I only have about 45 minutes worth of work at the most, and I will see all of you at the final. available right now with no waiting from modelroundup.com is the Atlantis Toy and Hobby Mack Bulldog Steak Truck. This one in the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey livery. I love these kits. I know they have a tanker version. I don't know if they have any other versions. I've built the log version. I've built the steak truck. Now I can't wait to build the tanker or any other version of these that ever comes out, because these are a joy to build each time. They're just enough different with the decals and the steak bed and all that stuff that it makes it fun each time. It's not a monotonous process. We can do different cabs. Now I've done the cab without the windshield. Next time I'm going to have to see if I can do the half cab or something a little different when we do the tanker truck. I don't know. And I hope that Atlantis will be coming out with that tanker truck. I don't have any preliminary information. I'm not a mind reader, and I don't have any inside information into the hobby companies, but I sincerely hope they will be. If these are successful, the logging truck must have sold enough that they want to do the steak truck and hopefully the tanker truck. The tanker truck, I want to kind of dent up that big tank and kind of scratch up. This one I did quite fresh, got a little bit of rust and grease on the chassis, the wheels, but otherwise the body is in good shape. I use a primer so that when I spray yellow, which is a very light color, you can see just some shadows underneath it. So it doesn't look so modelish, it looks more realistic. I went with the painted bed with the wood stakes and the wood bed itself, and then the metal braces I did in the yellow, because you can see on the ends, you can see all the little yellow ends and you can kind of see underneath it, and I love that look. The hood comes up and down quite easily, comes off without an issue. What I did was, I didn't have all the time to do all these little stripes and the curves in them and stuff, and I didn't want to tackle all of that. So what I was doing was, when I was looking at the decals, and I was applying all the other decals, and I was sticking all the little corners in here like it is on the box art. Those look beautiful. Got the Mack logo on there. Got the logo on the front just reversed from what it is here. Instead of doing yellow with black inside, I did black with yellow inside. I just like that look on mine. And then on these Tidewater Trucking logos, since I laid down the Ringling Brothers logos on the sideboards, they had these nice corner pieces on all these decals. These sweet little corners there. So I cut those corners out and I placed them in the corners of the cab, one right on the front of the hood. But this scroll work, I think someone from the Circus, they would have done stuff like that to dress this up a little bit. And I love it. It's definitely period looking. I used the license plate on the tailgate. I put it on the front bumper, figuring they're going to other areas. They're going to be checked. You know, there are crazy Circus people in our town. So the model has it on the front, actual steel. I put it on the wood. I got the crank on mine off the front, so they can crank start it. I did a brass moto meter on the top, and then I did white on the sides as it comes around. You'll see I did white on there and located those. We got our grab handles, which I put these lights up where the grab handles would be on the logging one, so that the lights were farther up and tucked more in. On this one, it's being used on roads and stuff, so I felt cool with the handles and the lights down low where they should be. We got our little side steps in there. I put the toolbox on the driver's side on this one, on the logging truck, which I'll link to at the end of this video. I did it the other way, and then I did a brass colored fire extinguisher on the fender there. Just love this kit. It is a ton of fun. I enjoy building it. Every single version that comes out, I wish there was more than just three versions. I wish they made a tow truck version. I wish they made a fire truck version. Maybe Atlantis, if they ever had the money, could work on all the different things we could set on that frame. A tow truck version would look awesome. A fire truck version, all kinds of stuff on here. A beer wagon with like the, you know, the stakes for the beer kegs and stuff like that. Who knows what they could do? Make it a root beer wagon if it has to be kid friendly to be sold in stores. Whatever. I think all of that would be absolutely awesome. I am so happy with this kit, and I'm happy that this is the first kit after the 55 Bel Air, and I had no issues with the paint whatsoever. I didn't have to fight anything. This kit just went perfect from beginning to end. So thanks to Model Roundup .com for sending this over. I'll link for this, and if they have the logging truck in stock, I will link to that as well, so you can build them both and get your fleet going like mine. Thanks for watching the workshop, and I'll see all of you at the next review.